Hey guys, Matt here from mksmarthouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to give you a demo of the network we're going to be creating. So the point of this demo is to show you the system in action as well as how it all works. Also, when each one of these four videos in the network series hits 100 likes, I will release the video of setting up the home automation server with OpenApp 2 sooner than it is planned. Anyway, let's start off with the device in action part. Let me just take out my phone, and as you can see, we have a couple different Wi-Fi networks. With the network, we have two sets of wireless. We have the guest Wi-Fi and the normal personal Wi-Fi. Then within those two sets, we have the 2.4 GHz and the 5 GHz. The 5 GHz is the faster one, and whenever possible, always use it. But some devices are not 5 GHz capable, so they would have to use the 2.4 GHz. Another thing is that with this network and the wireless, I have full Wi-Fi coverage throughout the property from outside to the second floor, which for this smart house system is very necessary. We can also access any one of these Wi-Fi networks from anywhere around the house. With this network, we can also connect many wired devices that we have. To end off what it can do, I'm just going to show you the speed test of the wired network and the wireless network. It can handle quite a bit. So now let's go over how it all works. Down here in the basement, we have the main network, which consists of the modem, router, and Ethernet switch. We start off by getting the internet from the ISP through this coaxial cable, which then goes to the modem and gets outputted through this red Ethernet cable and goes into the router. The router is the brain of the network as it assigns IP addresses and talks with the modem. This router also is one part of the wireless setup. Then we have this yellow Ethernet cable, which goes to the Ethernet switch, and it distributes the Ethernet signal between all the wired devices in the house, including the two Wi-Fi access points that I have. One of the access points is in the garage, so I have an Ethernet cable running to there, and then I have another access point in my room where I have an Ethernet jack that goes to the Ethernet switch. The access points are what are responsible for increasing the Wi-Fi range, which is why I have two of them in addition to the main router's Wi-Fi. I'm not saying they are necessary to everyone, but what is necessary is complete Wi-Fi coverage throughout the entire home, so all the future sensors and devices can connect to it. That's it. That is the network we will be creating in the next couple of videos. First is the hardware video, where we will connect everything. Next is the software video, where we configure everything. And then lastly, we have the final installation video, where we mount and install everything in their final positions. If you have a network already, which you probably already do, then you should still watch these videos as there might be something I do differently than you. Also, even if you have a network, you can get some ideas from mine on some upgrades you can possibly do, such as a new router or increasing the Wi-Fi range using access points. Some of you might be saying, just show us the smart home stuff, and I am. I am showing the complete process from start to finish of a smart home, and the network by far is the most important, because if you don't have a strong network, the communication between devices will be terrible and your smart home will fail. The point is, make sure you have a very stable and fast network, which you can watch these next videos to make sure. Alright, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below or head over to the mksmarthouse.com/forum where you have a better chance of getting it answered. Goodbye!